And I think we haven't asked Bob anything, and he's the person that handles the maintenance department. Do you have anything to add to this, Bob?
Well, the shortage, the backlog, we had a person. It helped. It doesn't look like we've accomplished a whole lot, but we have. And like you said, we have people that's got the overtime bank full. And last winter, they had some good paychecks, which once everything is full, there's not an option. You know, they get paid. It just, like you said, now they're trying to use some of that up. And like you said, you're still short a person. Even, well, actually, you're short two people, you know. And hard, difficult to schedule things and get things lined up and, well.
Well, and the other thing that we forgot about the water plant was they also hauled wastewater sludge. And I believe Mike worked 53 hours a couple weeks ago just trying to get that hauled out.
And maintenance also. So it was both of them.
So.
Are there any other comments or
questions?
Yeah.
Look at the insurance. What's our liability look like? Our insurance going to be on a part-time or a temporary employee?
It depends on if they're using our equipment. This discussion came up, actually during the personnel discussions, because one of the things they came up was using our equipment versus when you hire a contractor, typically a contractor will bring in their own equipment. So that's one of the elements of it that's usually a little more ideal than hiring a temporary or a part-time employee. In those type of cases, once they're using your equipment, there just becomes some liability concerns from that perspective. It usually prevents you from, in our case, it would prevent us from hiring anybody. Of course, I don't know why you would hire somebody under the age of 18, but I guess there is scenarios where you would. But it would have an impact on hiring anybody under the age of 18, because we have certain insurance limitations on what somebody under the age of 18 can actually perform on our behalf.
Okay. I'd just like to say that, having served on the personnel committee, I went into this with an open mind, not with any foregone conclusion as to which direction I would take. But after listening, especially to the department heads and the employees, I did come to the conclusion that I think we're getting further and further behind, and that's something that we really need to address. And I think the best solution is a full-time employee in the maintenance department. And as a result of that, I would like to make the motion that we do hire a full-time maintenance person.
Is there a second?
I'll second.
Are there any questions? I call for a vote. Councilman Berger?
No.
Rohrhardt? Hampton?
Yes.
Johnston?
Yes.
Bernie?
Yes.
Motion carried. Yes, Curtis?
Hey, how is this going to be posted?
It'll be posted to the public. I have actually a notice here for the paper.
With all of the talk that you guys have done in public, on the record, about hiring Hofford part-time, liking him, and creating this position so that he can come work for the city full-time, how would anyone else think that they would have a chance to come apply for this job and get it?
I don't think that is the case. I mean, one of the things that we were very clear when we went through the hiring practice for a temporary employee is we made it very clear to them that there were no, there would be no automatic hiring process, that there would be, it'd be opened up externally, and that we would take in applications. There will be a new interview process, and there will be a new recommendation made to the council. But I mean, I don't think in any perspective, I don't think us nor the temporary employee would have any expectations that this is in any way a done deal type of program.
And everybody on the council agrees with that, not a done deal?
As far as I'm aware, in fact, I would want it no other way. And if we find the best qualified
especially since how much of a limited pool we had to consider from. I mean, the last time we definitely would want to see what our options are as far as the talent pool is available to us for filling that position.
And advertising for a temporary part-time job or temporary job than a full-time job. You
know, a very different amount of applicants, yeah.
This job is going to start off at what rate?
Under the current terms, it would be roughly $15.70 per hour is what it pays. Give or take a few pennies.
What is the, what's a typical benefit package? You know, including membership at the SAC Community Center, health, everything. What's a, how much is a benefit package worth?
How much is it worth for a starting employee? You're probably looking in the neighborhood of, would you say $14,000 for that position, Sandy?
I never.
I would have to look at it roughly, but you'd probably be.
You say $14,000 is a ballpark?
Right, that would probably be a good ballpark.
Does that include all the insurance and everything you guys have to buy for them?
That would be included in that, yeah. And like I said, I'm just putting together.
So it'd be the $15 an hour plus the $14,000 a year?
Yeah. Okay. That's just a rough picture for you.
But it depends on whether they're single or married or.
Sure.
Right. Well, we wouldn't know any of that till after the hiring process as far as what their cost per benefit.
Well, thank you for answering all my questions.
Anything else?